nothing nobler or more admirable than when two people who see eye to eye keep house as man and wife, confounding enemies and delighting their friends.
Happy is the man who finds a true friend, and far happier is he who finds a true friend in his wife. My name is Lexford McNish,
and we are your masters of ceremonies
for this afternoon. At this time, we are about to introduce the bridal party, and I'm going to ask you to, well, before the bridal party, we're going to bring in the parents. At this time, I'm going to ask Mr. and Mrs. White to enter.
Isn't she lovely?
I don't know who she's walking with, but she's lovely. I don't know if you noticed that her two sons captured her. Her husband was not important to her anymore. Yeah? So. Oh, here they come. The GQs. Let's welcome the bridal party. The beautiful Sojini Cover, the bridesmaid.
And Ricardo Russell.
And of course, Sojini is the sister, or the twin sister, of the crew. Camille McGregor, bridesmaid.
And James Cover. And then they're switching around. This is Andre, of course. Just a handsome. Give him a hand,
Next welcome, Priscilla Montgomery.
Okay, here comes James.
Here comes Ashley Frederick.
And Andre Clark.
I know you haven't eaten yet, but you can give them a better hand. Thank you. That's
great. All right, the moment you have been waiting for, I'm going to ask you all to stand to your feet. As we bring in, and this is the first time I'm going to ever say this, bring in the bride and the groom, Mr. and Mrs. Dominique Cova!
Come on, they deserve a little bit more than that.
I'm
To eat. But before you do that, Janice Gale, are you here? Who is Janice Gale?
Here.
Here. Present teacher, say that.
Present.
All right, here you go. She's going to, she is going to bless the meal and the cake and the proceedings.
Thank you. I use this opportunity to say congratulations to Dominic and your royal wife. On behalf of Andrew, who was unable to be here, and the rest of the children, we wish you all the very best. You look beautiful. Taurus Riley, some folks to life this evening. She's royal. Bow your heads. Father, we thank you that your will is being done on earth as it is in heaven. As we prepare to die, we thank you for what is provided. We thank you for those who provided it. Pray that it will be nourishment to our bodies. And we thank you that the rest of this evening will be just wonderful because you will continue to be in our midst. We thank you in Jesus' name.
Amen. It makes any difference. I give you all my heart. Girl, my son sense anywhere you are. Maybe I'm a dreamer. You're still my queen. Your love's like a river, girl.
I certainly enjoyed my meal. I don't know about you, but mine was sumptuous. I'm filled to capacity. Of course, if you still feel peckish, help yourself, all right? Oh, for those who don't understand, if you still have the urge to eat, go ahead and enjoy some more, all right? I'm sorry. All right, listen. This thing always... Let me ask you all a question. I need for you to answer me, all right? How many wives are we men entitled to? All right. How many wives are we men entitled to?
One.
Okay, first of all, Dominique, please respond so that I don't get disrupted. Okay. Can you all just hit your glass one more time so that they can respond, please? All right, good. Thank you, Dominique. Now, let me hear from you. Is it one wife? Is it two wives? Is it four wives? Is it 16 wives?
One.
Is it as much as you want?
One.
Huh? Okay. I'm hearing like a rumbling going on around. But listen, okay. Who said more than 16? Put your hands up. Yeah. Okay, nobody? All right, who says less than 16 but more than one? All right.
Okay, who said one?
Yes.
One. Okay, so I see a few hands, but it means then that the others not sure what they really want. They're scared.
One at a time.
All right, someone say one at a time. You can have as much as you want, but only one at a time. All right, good. Sounds good. Okay, this is I've been to a few weddings my lifetime, including mine. And I always hear the preacher say, or the pastor, or the whoever is doing the sermon, he says, for richer, for poorer, for better, for worse. Now, listen. I love math. Math is my favorite thing to do. I like numbers. And when I hear for rich, for poor, for high, for better, for worse, and I put that together, I get at least 16. You understand? So, I mean,
one wife, one. Okay. They're all in that one.
But I think I like what Sister Stewart says. It says one at a time. All right? And please don't do nothing to get rid of the one that you have. Please, I beg you, I beseech you, in the name of Jesus. All right? Okay. At this time, we are going to continue into our program, and I'm going to ask Miss Lori Bitar to come forward, and she's going to give a toast. And then immediately following her, I'm going to ask Ashley, where are you putting her up? Okay, Ashley's going to come, and she's going to give a toast to the bride.
Well, I am honored to be here, and when Dominic asked me to do this, I got really nervous, and I usually don't. As you can tell, I kind of like to speak in front of a crowd, but this was kind of, it took me back. But I gave it some thought, and I watched how things unfolded today. And I really wanted to say that I've been a part of Dominic and James and his family life for a long time. They spent time with me back in 2004, 2005. And then later, I got to spend some time as Dominic's high school teacher in 2007. So when Dominic came to my school, we were kind of sorting things out, and I was about as crazy as I could have possibly been at that time of my life. And thank God for Dominic and James and Marcia, because these guys were my rock. And so when I thought about what would the toast say today, I wrote a book, and I'm the superhero, and my students are my sidekicks, and we fight the archenemies of education. Well, of the thousands and thousands and thousands of students I've worked with, Dominic is one of those chapters. And so, I'm even nervous. So what I thought about was, well, what would I say to Dominic and this beautiful woman who has made him so incredibly happy? And the whole theme on the hero is to ask teachers to take a look at themselves and adults and think about their behavior. And does it help or hinder? Does it engage or exclude? Does it resuscitate or ruin? Does it overjoy or obliterate? And so I would stop and say to you guys to be each other's hero. But you already knew that. I think the one thing I took away from today more than anything was to say to you in this toast, thank you both. Because the one thing you did for most of us in the room is you gave us hope today. We got to see the good guy win. And that doesn't happen very often in this lifetime. And I want you two to love each other and be together and to know that you gave us a beautiful, incredible day. So thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. Ariel has been a good friend of mine, my best friend, since I was about 7 years old. And to be standing here before everyone and these two today, it warms my heart. Ariel has always been such an inspirational person to me, and I'm just so happy to see that everything has worked out. And I remember something there. Well, as the weeks of admiration turns into months and turns into years, the fact that your love has stood the test of time is amazing, and it is a blessing I just want to reiterate that I'm so happy for the both of you, and I hope that you two continue to make each other happy. Thank you, everyone.
There's a story that is told about a couple and wife who was having an argument, and somehow they decided that they're not going to be talking to each other for a while. You know, they do the silent treatment. Anybody knows what that is? Married couples, you're very, very cordial. You just say what you have to say. So the husband was leaving for a flight the following morning at 5, you know, very early in the morning. He wanted to get up at 5, and he decided, boy, I don't want to be the one to talk to her first. So what he did, he wrote a note. And he said, honey, on the note, honey, please wake me up at 5 a.m. And he put it on her bedside table. And he felt good. He said, well, I communicated, but I wasn't the one who talked to her first. The next morning, he woke up at 9. He missed his flight, and he was upset. So he stomped, he went to find her, and on the table, he saw a note that said, wake up, honey. It's 5 o'clock. So who won? Nobody really. We're gonna ask Andre to come right now. He's gonna have a presentation. Andre. Sorry, Camille. Sorry, Camille Landos.
Good afternoon. I'm play Ribbon in the Sky.
Woo! Mr. Landos.
Come out.
I'm not gonna cry, so. All right.
right, I just want to say thank you, Dominic, for asking me to be here. Parents for putting everything, giving them full support on today to make this happen. And, I know Dominic for about since 2007, and that's where you know we met at Pentab. I don't know how you guys know Pentab. All right, it's been like 8 years. I know I joined the military. 2010. When I go away, when I come back, it's like we never skip a heartbeat. I come back and be like, oh, what's going on, man? You know. And okay, I'm not calmer now.
Okay.
But all I want to say is, you know, I know Dominic for 8 years, and ever since then, we. I've known Dominic for about 8 years. I could be gone for years at a time, and we come back together, and we never skip a heartbeat. And twins. I'm also a twin. And I'm like the twin brother he always wanted. So, that being said, but as you know, I'm a really friendly person in the church, and that's how me and Don became friends, and me and Ariel became friends, and that's how we have, I'm the mutual friend, as you wrote in reading the programs, and that's how they met. But me and Dominic, we're like Lewis and Clark. We're always going on adventures. You know? And now it's time for me to step down as Clark and allow Ariel to come. And they can go further and have future adventures and love from here forth on. So I will be the third wheel. She will know, she's the third wheel, like when we're at, like that short time we're at church and we're all conversating and we're talking, and she's just like on the opposite side or something. But now it's time for me to be in the back and you two going forward. But I'll still be there though. All right, I'm going to leave you with this. How do you know she's the one? First, you know she's the one by you calling everybody her name, even me. call me Ariel. When your family loves her and take her in as her own, both families. When there is nothing you would do to change about her, when she's your best friend. The thought of marrying her will not scare you, but ask her dad, her dad and her hand in marriage will. Here's a toast. For a lifetime of happiness and love to Ariel and Dominic.
I'm gonna see what your response is, and then I'm gonna give you a response, all right? Response. Dominique, do you believe you married Miss Wright?
I know I
You know you married, you know you married Miss Wright, right? Okay. Now, the question I'm asking you, what is her first name? Okay, think again. I'm gonna give one more try. What is her first name? Huh?
Mrs. Wright.
Mrs. Wright, you're getting very close, but this is her first name. Put her hand over the ears, husbands. Listen. Dominique. Always. And I guess you all don't get it. She is Mrs. Wright, but her first name is Always. Always right. Okay, Dominique, so don't forget that. All right. All right. I hope it didn't fly over some of your head, all right? Joan, did you just get it? Okay, at this time, we're going to have the cutting of the cake. I'm going to ask Dominique to escort his beautiful bride.
Okay. And as each life is different and each marriage is different, we're going to have them serve each other the way they see fit.
Also, I would like to say thank you for the support that we've received from both families, mine's and Ariel's, loved ones, friends, for being there, helping us in the preparations of everything. I'm like really excited right now. I didn't have anything prepared, so excuse me if I like stutter or miss a beat, but I'm really excited. I'm looking forward to what the future has for both Ariel and I. I embrace it. I'm looking forward to learning as we go through. We don't know it all right now, but as we get there, we'll take care of it. Also, I would like to say that now my family has just expanded and gotten much bigger, which I'm looking forward to spending some more time with both her family and vice versa. And thank you once again for everyone for attending. I'm gonna pass it over to my wife now.
Thank you.
coming. I know we have people that came from Jamaica, from California, from all over, and I just want to say I appreciate it. And I hope you guys enjoyed yourselves, and thank you.
Congrats, and I wish you guys all the best, and may God bless you in the future.
All right. If you ever thinking about having a dream, guys, I think I have one.
Brothers and sisters, it's always been like, we've been close, and since Dominic came, she kind of... It had to be somebody, I'm glad it's him. So he did take care of her, and he treats her right, so... If you guys ever need anything, you know, we're always here as well. All right?
A little guy that grown up in us so much. We started out together many, many years ago. He was a little small something. His brother was even smaller. But even though he was larger, he was smaller. But Dominic has always been there. Just a funny thing that I have to really remind him of. My mother now is 93 years old. Many years ago, when we were scout, he was scout, he gave my mother a picture. Now she's 93. She'll be 94 the 1st of May. I told her yesterday, I said, you know, Dominic is getting married. She said, Dominic? Not the little tall, skinny guy. Said, he gave me that picture on the wall. She pointed to a picture. And it's a funny thing, she's 93, she can remember back there then, but she can't remember the next day. Wow. But I just want to say that you're really blessed, and you'll always be blessed. And remember, I'm always there for you. If you guys ever need me, I'm there. Okay?
Hello and good afternoon to everyone.
Good afternoon.
Dominic and Ariel, I greet you in the precious name of our Savior. On behalf of Peter and myself, we want to wish you guys a heartfelt congratulations. And you have done the right thing. It's the official thing and the honorable thing to do. And irrespective of what people might say, married life is a good life. So best wishes today, tomorrow, always and forever. And it is so befitting to see your teacher here. I just couldn't get over him, you know, because he must have felt so good to see you. Because in this time that we are living in, not many teachers get to see their student get married. So congratulations once again, and God bless.
I am Mrs. Jones. Avril, I know you don't know this is George, you know, Sister Glory. And Dominic, I just want to say I'm so proud to be a part of this evening. I know that Brother and Sister White has done a good job, and we get a friend and, you know, and a good associate. And I just want to say about Dominic, Sister Lassie has done a wonderful job. I knew him when he was like this. No one looking up in his face. He's always well-mannered, well-spoken, calm. He's a gentleman. And I just look at you two today, and I just give the Lord thanks for you. And I know that you're going to make it to the 100 or the 99. You two are going to be together because of the homes that you're coming from, the background that you were brought up. You weren't dragged up. There were times spent to put time and energy in you both. And I just want to say congratulations and God bless you.
Dominic and Maria. Okay, congratulations guys. Dominic, my twin brother. I feel like I'm losing half of myself. You guys have been together a long time, and I've always respected and
hold it closer.
What I saw between you two. I'm very happy that you guys have finally tied the knot. And now I have a sister, a twin sister, that I've always wanted. But I'm here for you guys. If you ever need anything, I'll be here. And don't forget about me, Dominique.
Good evening, everyone. Me, Ariel. I've known you for over 24 years. And I just want to wish both of you God's blessing, lots of love and happiness. Congratulations again to both of you.
I want to thank Brother Big Nish for lightening up the mood. I ain't going to come up here and cry. I just want to say congratulations to my brother and Ariel.
The music is making him cry.
I want to wish y'all the best, you know. Marriage is a journey, and my brother's a strong guy, and I know that he's going to be a good rock, but Ariel to follow. And I just want to wish y'all the best.
It's really amazing that years ago, over 20 years ago, in the 90s, I was attending a church in Fort Lauderdale, and I met the two parents there, the two sets of parents, it's the Marcia and the Whites, and Peter. And I got entangled with the family from then, not knowing that I would be standing here this many years later, looking at their children getting married. I'm just so happy for you guys. I really deem it an honor to stand in this category. But what I want to say is more so for the guests that are here. We all know that a marriage is not very easy, because we're taking two different people who grow up, even though good homes, but they are different people. And they're now coming together to build a home and to make a family. So I want to encourage you that your journey with them does not end here after the dessert, but that you continue to pray for them, to check up on them, you know, to send little encouraging words every now and again, and to remember that this walk, though fun and very rewarding, is not always easy. Can you promise to do that? Pray for them, encourage them, and just uphold them. Congratulations, guys, and I wish you all the best. If there's no one else, going once, twice, one more. And if there's anybody else, can you come right now? Because if you don't come now, then that will be the end of the toast.
Yeah, I'm very happy to be here. I'm Ariel's uncle. I'm very, very happy for Ariel. And I'm sorry my mom is not here to see Ariel. I remember when I was growing up, she and my mom had some nice time. I'm gonna give you a secret. When you get married, two can be fire, one have to be water. If the two can be water, that will be better. And there's another thing, the communication is good. It's good to have communication. If you don't have communication, that's very bad, you know? And be an example for others. I'm so happy, I love you so much. I'm going 32 years now. I find no fault with Mary. I'm going to pray for you. I love you so much. I'd like to see young people get married. Because nowadays, they just do shaka. They call it shaka. My son say, Daddy, what do you say? I say shaka. Right. So I love you so much. God bless you.
Yes. I have known the Green since I was a little girl growing up. I'm from Jamaica. We all from the same church, Sister Marcy. My uncle, Bishop Morris, was the pastor for that church that they are from. And I don't expect better from Sister Marcia raising her kids. Deacon Green, can you please stand, Deacon Green? That's Sister Marcia's father. And Bishop Morris, who was my uncle, Deacon Green was very close to Bishop Morris all over the years in his ministry. And Deacon Green has done a great job growing up his girl, his girls. And Sister Annie's, that's, we are from RT. Sister Annie's, please stand. That's Sister Annie's. Amen. We all grew up from Jamaica and we all migrate here. So I know them all. And I remember Dominique, I used to run a race to get Dominique and Sejin on Sunday mornings. And we used to hold them in our hands, not just like, oh, you're holding that little baby. That's how I used to hold Dominique and Sejin. And I'm so proud of you today, Dominique. God bless you and Ariel. Ariel, I know you're from a good home. And I know you're a good person. My spirit sanction it. You'll get a good wife. And the Bible says, leave your mother and father and cleave to your wife, and cleaving is together. I just made 20 years of marriage. To God be the glory for the things he has done. Lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be lifted up, ye everlasting doors, and let the King of glory come in. Do not bring a second party into your marriage. It will not work. Don't let no friends tell you what to do. Don't let nobody tell you to go there or go there, and don't say anything to your husband. You work together. Communication is the key to marriage. Communication is the key in keeping a good home. And my husband could not be here, but I am here to represent my family from New York. And let me tell you, Dominic, it was not a guess whether I want to be here or not to support you. I love you, and Sejini and James. God is going to give you all a beautiful wife to James. I hope the next time I come is yours. Amen. To God be the glory, and I just love the Lord because God has been leading me along the way. And the same God that keep me can keep you too. God bless you, and I love you, and you will always be in my prayer. Amen.
If God is not a central and an essential part of your marriage, then God help you. My encouragement is to make sure that you stay close to God. First, be committed to God. And marriage, as I said, is a commitment. You've committed to each other, to the thick or thin, whether things are going good or things are going bad. It's a commitment. It's not how you feel. Feeling comes and feeling goes. But because you have committed to each other and you are committed to God, then that's what's going to keep your marriage going. All right? So remember that it's not just dependent on you. You have to make sure that God is a central ingredient in your marriage. All right? God bless you. At this time, we're gonna close off, and you're being served dessert, so you can enjoy it after the fact. But I'm going to ask you all to stand, and we're going to close in prayer. I'm going to ask you all to just reach your hands and lift your voices, and let's just pray for them. We thank you for your love and your mercy. You're a good God. This day was ordained before the foundation of the world, and God, you are faithful to that which you have promised. And we thank you for Ariel, and we thank you for Dominique. We commit them to you this day. They have made a vow, God, Jesus Christ, unto you in the presence of man, that they will be man and wife. God, you promised to honor them. You promised to bless them. You promised to be with them, oh God. And your words are true and your promises are true. So, God, we know that you will be with them. But help them, Jesus, to let you be what you want to be in their lives and in their marriage. Bless them abundantly, but more important, let them prosper in you. In the name of Jesus, God, as they go, Lord, we ask you, Lord, to let your anointing be upon them, dear Jesus. Lord, God, order their steps. Give them wisdom, give them direction, give them instruction. As they get to know each other, God, help them, oh God, Jesus, to make sure that you are in their hearts and they love you with all their hearts. Bless them right now and bless the family. In the name we pray, amen and amen. Yeah, yeah.
soul. I want the world.